customized a walker gear just for you.
I painted flames on the sides.
I've taken the liberty of calling it the D-Walker. It's armed with a
It takes a genius
gun.
On the level of Hugh Emmerich to figure out your naming convention.
Yeah.
I thought our best move was to prove to the UN through the IAEA that we had no nuke. Of course, I was
Look, you're just confused
place,
by overhearing our communications. It's a cat.
The boss wasn't
nuke is the name of the cat.
Yeah.
I didn't know anything.
Nobody can back that up.
Yeah.
All the evidence is at the bottom of the ocean.
Let's just go deep sea diving. I'm in a real big pickle now.
I'm going to invent a submarine with legs.
Eureka!
I'm just imagining if Huey ever got like a job developing like more normal, like, you know, not nothing used for military purposes, just like, oh, I'm designing new household appliances. I'm making a new microwave. The fucking microwave would get up and walk away. The next upcoming mission is a weird one. You know, it's basically, this is a mandatory mission, and it gets you the interpreter for this area. It's kind of broken.
And fun, great.
Yeah, you'll see why. But yeah, we're gonna do two runs here, one with Big Boss and one with Vapor Snake. Big Boss is gonna be the one showing off just, like, everything wrong with this mission. And also, I gotta get to be about... If I want this mission to work correctly, it has to be about 6 p.m. when you start the mission. Otherwise, things ain't gonna go so good. It's probably the most frustrating mission in the game. Like, there's a couple other spots later on that are... can be a little frustrating because they're just kind of... they're like difficulty spikes. There are a couple of, like, fights later on where it's like, oh god, I wasn't prepared to fight stuff like this, and you'll get real messed up. This is more of a, I don't think they had time to, like, finish the mission.
Yeah.
So, the first issue with this mission is, at least if you start it not from the helicopter, but just from the open world, like that Jeep that drives by, they're carrying a POW in the back of the Jeep. The first time you start this mission, that POW does not end in the Jeep, and instead they just stay behind the rock the Jeep drives from. And so, because that POW is not where they should be here, it breaks the scripting for the rest of the mission. You just have to restart mission, and then the POW will be in the fucking Jeep. If, like, say you see that POW is there, he's being escorted only by one soldier, and they're going down a road where there are no other guards. It's really easy to rescue this POW. Don't do that! It breaks the scripting for the mission! That POW has to be at a spot later on, untouched, or else things go wrong. The interpreter is going one by one to the other people that we were not hired to rescue, and interrogating them first before they go interrogate the Viscount and then execute him. But that means those guys need to interrogate every POW beforehand. So if suddenly the POW is not there, they just don't know what to do and all their scripting breaks, and then they never go to interrogate the Viscount. And so then you have no fucking clue where the Viscount is. Now, if you just want to play this mission and, like, there are other ways to figure out, you know, where the Viscount are, but you might not know what they are, and you just kind of accidentally stumble upon them, or you accidentally just stumble upon the Viscount himself. But one of the optional mission, like, objectives is to hear all of the interrogations. Now, if you're going for 100%, you need to do this, and you're going to be real mad because you're going to spend 5 hours in this mission wondering why they never interrogate all the people. So, like, you know, they got in that Jeep, and then they'll be driving to some other prisoners to interrogate. One of those prisoners was that guy from the very beginning of the mission that I said, don't touch him. Because they'll go there, and their scripting is waiting for two POWs to be there, and if there's only one, it's not like they go like, oh, guess we can't interrogate him. They just stand there forever for the rest of the mission. and they don't fucking talk. Even if both PLWs are here, the scripting for these guys can still break. They'll walk right up to the PLWs, they'll get the other lady, and they'll get her out of the cage she's being held in, and then they'll still just stand there and never talk to the PLWs. And that's because their scripting will break based on time of day. That's why I made it 6:30, almost 6:30 p.m. when I started the mission, because by the time I get here, several in-game hours have passed. And if it's like beyond like 11 p.m. or maybe midnight, that's when their scripting breaks and they'll just stand here instead of talking. Even if all the other things, other factors in this mission are going right, if you accidentally set off like, the base going to caution mode, or even just like some guys are investigating a sound, they call it in, that can break the scripting also. This specific interrogation is usually where the game breaks. Here's something else, like, here's an example. Like, it was like 3 or 4 in the morning instead, so all these guys are here.
Mm-hmm.
Just standing. And you can, like, smoke a phantom cigar, and hours will pass, and they'll still be standing there, and nothing ever happens. And some people have suggested, like, oh, just restart from checkpoint, and a lot of the times, it'll fix the scripting. That's not the case. If the time is wrong, and all that other shit. Here's another dumb bug, though. Sometimes they will execute the POWs before they can even interrogate them. And on top of that, like, after they shoot them, they will then go, whoa, who shot these bodies? Where did those gunshots come from? And then they go on alert because they shot their own guns.
Wow, it should be really easy for you to take these people apart. They're idiots.
Like, they call in an alert because they shot their own guns. Fuck.
You're just seeing the first stages of a cover-up. That's what it is.
So, we kind of fast-forwarded a full in-game day because the mission was still kind of broken. In that we... At this point, you just have to wait for the interrogator to go to the meeting point where they're going to bring the Viscount. But they do that very slowly, and they do it in a strange roundabout way where they don't walk straight to the thing. They just kept, like, walking in circles around a building for a while before they went to the fucking building. So, now they're here. In fact, the Viscount was late to the meeting, or not the Viscount, the interpreter was late to the meeting. He's supposed to get there first, but the Viscount was brought there before he even got there. And I still had to wait a bunch.
Somebody is not gonna be happy, and apparently it's me, actually.
And there's still one more way for this part to go wrong, specifically if you're trying for the bonus objective of hearing all of the interrogations.
Mm-hmm.
You saw how when I got close to those other POWs, they kind of like fall over so that you can Fulton them. Obviously, everybody's going to want to try and listen to the conversation when they're pretty close by so that they can then swoop in and rescue the guy quickly. There's a window in the backside of this building. If you sit by that window to listen to the thing, that's actually close enough to the Viscount's bubble of rolling over that he will stop answering questions and he'll just roll the fuck over because he wants you to rescue him. Even though there's like a wall between you and he has no idea that you should be there. But anyways, Vapor Snake, he's gonna have fun. But also, he lost so much blood fighting that bear, he's actually getting a blood transfusion right now. Like, look at that. They got a little drip and everything hooked up to him. And also, check this out. Keep your eye on the Jeep. It's like his seat was spring-loaded.
What are you doing? If the interpreter doesn't show up, they won't be able to interrogate anyone. Then they'll just kill the target.
I really love Ocelot's tone there. What are you doing?
Stop throwing yourself at everybody. And I do mean that emotionally, boss. You get attached too soon. You're wearing your heart on your sleeve and you ain't even got sleeves.
It's just the way he says it, it's like this funny mix of like disappointment, but already like he already knew he was gonna do something dumb like this.
Your own boss. Well, we'll just have to interrogate him to find out where the target is.
Even Miller gets disappointed in you. Also, look at this. They have their own decoys.
Amazing.
This is a list of prisoner detainment locations.
It seems like I was on your jock for no good reason, boss.
You're doing great, actually. In fact, it seems like it's probably just saving a lot more time than if you just followed this guy around for half an hour.
Anyway, I hope this guy was worth it.
Yeah.
And isn't some sort of monstrous scumbag.
Boss, one of the other British prisoners filled us in about the Viscount.
It turns out
he's a two-faced son of a bitch.
No.
He was planning to secure the MPLA's oil field rights for himself.
No.
The quote-unquote, the Viscount.
Yeah.
He doesn't get a special code name. Like, if when he's in your base, he's just called the Viscount.
great.
Yep. That's the name he's stuck with now for the rest of his life. It's been legally changed.
Really, it's less about quiet herself, but what she represents in broader trends.
Yeah. Also, we painted the whole base tactical gunmetal gray.
They were listening to me however many episodes that was ago.
But yeah. It's very hard to not talk about Quiet and not bring up Hideo Kojima's chain of tweets.
Mm-hmm.
About like, hey, everyone had words to say after Quiet's reveal. Hey, you'll be ashamed of your words and deeds when you find out the reason Quiet is mostly naked.
I'm very confused about the alleged deeds. I'm pretty sure it was entirely words, right? Like, nobody was...
So, everyone, prepare yourself to be ashamed of your words and deeds.
She breathes through her skin.
Ah.
Clothing would suffocate her.
What about 100% cotton?
What if we just gave her a sweater that, like, breathes a lot?
She doesn't eat either?
Never. She doesn't poop either, don't forget that.
Photosynthesis. Photosynthesis.
Well, then why are you keeping her in a basement, you freak?
The reason why you should be ashamed of judging Quiet's character design is because she breathes through her skin.
Mm-hmm.
I've had drug resistance.
Even when this stuff happens, some people are like, oh no, I'm sure there's a deeper reason that will make you feel bad, but no. That's it. She breathes through her skin.
I think the more important statement came a few days before the words or deeds. Tweets, if I remember correctly. I know it came first, just the distance time I might be forgetting. The statement that she was designed with figure purchasers and cosplayers in mind.
Yeah.
It was blatantly and explicitly just like, people will buy this shit.
Yeah.
That was the first statement.
Look, we're Metal Gear, we have normal action figures, but we've already made, like, Big Titty Sniper Wolf anime action figures, so why don't we make a character that's just that from the start, so we don't have to redesign her character later?
He's been in Afghanistan for 9 years.
He's the one who's really behind that base attack.
Alright.
He forced me into that research.
What kind of research?
He was working at a Soviet research lab in Afghanistan before the Soviet invasion of Afghanistan. I just want to make that clear.
One of the things I wish you could do is, like, at least for the main strut of each unit, it would be nice if there's, like, one building you could go into to do something. Mm-hmm.
And one has the seal in it, and one
Yeah, and each one just has another lady from Metal Gear just, like, cordon off in it. You're like, why are you here? Why did nobody tell me?
It's Meryl's mom. Nobody knows what she's doing here.
Yeah, the boss is there for some reason. Oh, hey, Strangelove's back. We just didn't tell you. We've been trying to keep it a secret from you, but you just keep stumbling upon all of them.
Are you drinking?
Whoa. Big Boss just goes in and thinks, I should be drinking too. So he just opens his mouth. Wow, Quiet. She's so smart. This is the way to do it.
There's no guarantee, no reason to believe she would come back with you.
Yeah.
There's nothing damn fine about this.
She would just disappear into the wilds of Africa and rejoin the cipher immediately.
Wait a minute, that thing costs a lot of money!
Miller, you may be second in command, but we don't give a fuck about your opinions at all. Shoot the helicopter, Quiet! Woo!
Looks like you've gotten used to working with Quiet.
I don't know about getting used to working.
I've already talked it over with the R&D team.
Yeah, that's always a little abrupt. It's just like, nah, I don't know. I'm pretty sure no. And then it's like, well, you can work with Quiet now, boss.
Only Cypher would be capable of making something like that happen. So, boss, eliminate the walker gears at the time.
I really like that,
village, just like the MPLA.
No matter what happens,
do, the PF will
that Miller just immediately blames Cypher.
Yeah.
He could stub his toe. He could get a muscle cramp. It's fucking Cypher, boss. So, Quiet is probably the best buddy in the game, especially, like, when you develop more equipment for her. Because she can, you can just tell her to go attack an outpost and she'll kill everyone there on her own. You can just sit there and she like plays the game for you. So going in ahead of time, before actually starting the mission here, it lets you kind of just like, there's less guys here before you do the mission. And so it kind of just easily lets you like go in and destroy all of their defenses. and doing that means that you can very easily complete the actual mission in, like, 2 minutes. It's great. Oh, and I should mention, Quiet, the lady she is based on, her actress is, her name is Stephanie Justin. She is a actor, singer, and model. She actually did a Let's Play of Metal Gear Solid 5.
Yeah, doesn't she just, like, love being quiet?
Yeah, she seems to love being quiet. So, good for her.
The character, that is. It's very confusing.
Yeah, it is. Okay, Quiet might have a really goofy, horny design, you know, but she's still a really good character, and I'm just like, I don't know. Like, despite how much she's in the game, her own little subplot is pretty short, and I don't think it's anything that special or good, really. I don't know, it'll be a long time before we see that shit, really, but...
Right. I mean, I'm sure people have been expecting me to, like, say shit, but I will when I have shit to say. How about that?
Yeah.
Like, yeah.
You're the one I've chosen to live.
Tell the story.
So, like, another thing that can happen with Quiet is, even if you don't tell her to attack, like, she's only scouting, if you get caught, she will shoot whoever caught you.
Nice.
Like, immediately. So, like, even,
subject on board. Leave the rest of us.
Like, you know, you get caught and you go into reflex mode. Like, the instant it turns on, you immediately hear her gunfire. So you're just watching in slow motion, knowing this man's already destined to die. And you can't do anything but just wait for the bullet to hit him in the skull.
Just in slow motion mouthing, I'm sorry.
Dancing with tears in my eyes. That's what that one is. Old. That's the word we got.
You can make old boys.
Yep.
Is there a hammer we could put on the emblem?
There might be, yeah.
Oh.
I forget what all the emblems are, but there's a chance there's a hammer. Just like with Dee Dee, if you just, like, look at her, it does increase your friendship a little bit. And also her reaction to you looking at her changes, like, the more friendly you've become with her. Right now, she just, like,
I'm a little nervous about what top-level friendliness gets you.
It's bad. I mean, it's Hideo Kojima, and he was already too horny to not make a sniper character that was, like, you know, looking like that.
I just worry about her crawling through gravel.
But we also developed one of my favorite outfits in the game, just because it's both useful and it looks really goofy. Also, we need some potasmin. But, we go to our camo, go all the way to the bottom, we've made the battle dress, and now he looks like a Michael Bay's Ninja Turtle.
Hell yes!
Look at him, he's so thick now!
Oh my goodness, God, it's like a Christmas story, I can't put my arms down!
Yeah, that is absolutely something like three other people have to help him put on, right? There's no way you could put that on yourself.
Just look at the contrast between them!
I know.
It's that scene in Friends when Joey puts on all of Chandler's clothes at the same time. I might have that backwards, but still.
So, doing this mission the quick way is basically just shooting them from the sky with the helicopter's minigun. And it's pretty easy to do that if you go in beforehand and just blow up their anti-air stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Because, like, despite there being a decent amount of guys, they can't really do much with just their rifles. Transportation specialist is very good to get if you haven't already found one by this point. Because you need him to upgrade your Fulton balloons more. And at this point in the game, we're suddenly going to get a lot of missions where we need to be Fultoning very heavy things.
Yeah. Okay. So that's the kind of transportation that they're a specialist in.
And really, like, I don't know if you really need them. You just need to go to the R&D team and go, like, can you make the balloon lift heavier things? What if there were three balloons in my Fulton?
What if bigger?
What if just big? Look, I'm called Big Boss for a reason. What if big? After that point, he just needs to get, like, the mother base graphic designer just to just make posters to put in all of R&D that just say, what if big?
What if big?
That's just really the design mantra for upgrading all of our shit. Like, either the thing needs to be bigger, or it needs to make explosions that are bigger.
Like, one of the posters is just a walker gear next to Sethalanthropus. Like, come on, what if big?
Come on.
You can't let them outbiggin' us.
All right, so this is mission 16. This is a mission that, like, if you just say mission 16, other people who played Metal Gear Solid 5 go, fuck that. Because this mission can very easily be frustrating. And what's annoying about it is it doesn't get frustrating until the very end of the mission.
Your objective is to steal an entire truck from a PF convoy.
Hell yeah.
The whole truck. For the most part, this mission is just going to be one take, and it's just Venom Snake. We'll do a brief aside to show, like, the easiest way to do this with Big Boss. But with this mission, even though there's, like, other ways to do it, you can kind of get the gist just from just doing it this one way. Also, I only want to do it this one time because I fucking hate this mission. I am going to be using, like, one mod, and that is just to alter, so basically anytime Quiet is ready to shoot somebody, she starts humming into the radio, but it's a very short loop. It's like a 5 or 6 second hum at most.
And you're gonna mod that into a vuvuzela.
Yeah. No, I'm just gonna mod it so that she's not constantly humming, because it gets annoying and repetitive very quickly. There might be, like, one Jeep that's a little bit faster than her, but just barely.
Oh shit.
Yep.
That's a hell of an escort they got. I was expecting a second truck with, like, 10 guys in it.
Yeah, this can be one of the issues, because, you know, you hear escort, and you do think it's just going to be guys in some normal vehicles. And so then you come into this mission, you know, with just stealth gear and no powerful weapons, and it's like, fuck, it's a tank. Hey, you should hit the brakes. So there are mods that let you play as Quiet in the game. But actually, just a week or so ago, in late July, Konami just randomly updated the game and lets you play as Quiet now. Although it's not just in the normal single player, it's for the multiplayer stuff, that we have yet to get to. But, so the mod is still relevant to just let you be Quiet for these parts, but, it's weird that Konami, like, a couple times, like, every year, they're still updating the game. It's so weird. Also, if you want to stop a vehicle, if you have a strong enough gun, you can just shoot their tires out.
Hey!
Pretty handy.
I think you found the truck.
Yeah.
Oh man, I love it when these guys fight the Power Rangers.
They really do look like putties. Alright, this is why this mission is super fucking frustrating. So here's the issue. Like, they are kind of dumb when they haven't caught you yet. They don't do much. But, you know, you've seen what the skulls do when they're aware of you. So if you come in here with the stealth gear only, you got one shot to get this right, buddy. Alright, got a big balloon. But check this out. They could pop the balloon.
What? Fuck that.
Yeah.
Fuck that.
So now all four of these skulls are aware of me, shooting me. You gotta be careful if you're fighting them. If you got rocket launchers and stuff, don't shoot them when they're close to the truck, because if you blow up the truck, it's game over. So while they do, you know, some of the similar things, they run around, teleport, shoot you, they have the same guns, they're just a lot stronger. Like, on top of being able to summon those rocks for cover, they can also lift them into the air and throw them at you telekinetically, like that. Or they would throw it, but they took some damage, so they decided to fuck off.
Hooray, Quiet.
Thanks, Quiet. And also, look at this. I killed him, but now he has a second health bar.
Jesus, come on.
And they can
on.
Summon the rocks underneath your feet, and now the rocks blow up. But yeah, that is a special trait of this other unit of skulls with the rock powers, is that they can grow this second armored health bar. It sucks. We're good. I mean, they might be able to shoot the Jeep, but zigzag a bit.
Yeah, I think you should be in the clear.
Yeah, probably. I mean,
oh, Jesus.
They can't shoot while sprinting, so that's good at least. Oh, wait, they can just dive kick your Jeep. I should also mention there's one other thing that happens in that mission. Specifically, you can just follow the escort unit and the truck. Hi, Quiet. And every time they get to a new checkpoint, there's a little discussion between, like, the truck driver and, like, some other people at the checkpoint. It's nothing that important, though. It's just him going, like, boy, I bet there's something fucking weird in this truck. And then they're like, don't even think about it. Don't. Just deliver the truck. Oh, welcome back.
Snake.
It has been many months since the previous update due to so many things. But let's just take a look at our pictures, our photo of our children. Hi, kids.
The Hall of Fame.
We have another picture of all of our kids. Oh my god, we have so many children now.
And boy, are my arms tired. Is that how that? Never mind. Boy, are my sperm tired.
I got sick from just standing guard at her cell. I won't stand on the same platform as that witch. She hit me for no reason.
She called me
what
names.
Is this, a private army what, or
did
a
she?
Why are you
did
believing
she?
Me? Why?
They're all serious. They're faced with something they don't understand, and a kind of mass hysteria has broken out. I've gotten wind of countless plots to take her out.
They no mostly involve burning sage under the full moon.
Put yourself in her shoes, assuming they see her as a prisoner here. No,
they've started putting a circle of salt around her cage.
She deserves to be treated humanely. I always thought our men were a bit more noble-minded, but
it turns out we're just a shitty bunch of terrorists out in the ocean.
While looking through the scope with one eye, she can look for new targets with the other.
I love that. That's because I just want to see them animate Quiet with, like, chameleon eyes going in different directions. Just imagine that.
I told you she's a
freak. It doesn't make sense no any other way.
Yeah. No, Miller just going like, see, I told you, she's a freak. And it's just like, Miller, that's just like a cool party trick she can do. Hey, Quiet.
Hey, Quiet, are you a man-eater? You get it? Okay, bye-bye.
I guess they must have built that cell before they, before we captured Quiet. It's like a weird, like, almost quarantine cell. It's like they were expecting somebody with cooties ahead of time. I just think it's funny, like, yeah, Quiet is super powered, but she still looks like she weighs a normal amount. But whenever she jumps from the helicopter, she makes a really fucking loud sound, like she's made out of metal, like she's a robot.
She got one of them Wolverine skeletons.
Yeah, it's got just full of adamantium.
I'm surprised it hasn't come up yet, frankly.
Yeah, I mean, it's we'll eventually learn more about how quiet works and shit.
You'd expect her to have, like, hollow bird bones, but no. That's how she gets you.
Boss, she's comprised entirely of bird cells.
Yeah,
I've been doing a lot of fetish art. I mean,
day trading.
We'll figure out what to do with Huey later.
Don't leave him in a room alone with Miller.
Yeah.
Or pretty much anyone but Ocelot, I think.
Yeah. Ocelot's just, like, literally got him on a leash. It's kind of weird. Also, some other Metal Gear things have happened in between this update and the last. Mainly, everyone keeps sending me messages, and yes, I know, there is a spirit in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate of Paz, and yes, I know that her effect is that you come equipped with a bomb. I know they made that fucked up reference in Smash Bros.
And it should have been two. Come on. You should get two bombs.
You should get two bombs. Oh, man. Can't believe Bowser is working for Cypher. I know that, like, it might be a while, but there will be another Metal Gear game someday. Like, it's too much of a...
I love the resignation in your voice about
it's,
that.
It's too much of a big IP. Konami will at some point make a new Metal Gear game. Or, at some point, they will sell the rights. But I don't think they will. I think they'll hold on to it. It's just like, if there ever is another Metal Gear game, is there any way you could
Whether
add...
Whether it's in 2 years or 20,
yeah,
it will happen.
Is there any way that you could add even more functions to the cardboard box? It has so many in this game. It is already a Swiss Army box. Like,
could you put a refrigerator in it? Just get real back to basics with the box.
This side-up we're doing is a very important one because it unlocks like a big gameplay feature for you. This is extracting the legendary gunsmith.
Ooh.
Once we get the gunsmith, we can like get extremely tactical with all of our guns.
A what now?
Metal Gear just tipped its hat at us.
A who now?
A 100-year Native American nuclear physicist. That sounds like Metal Gear to me.
Excuse me?
It's not around until this point in the game that conversation is one that can come up between soldiers, specifically in Africa. I did this section so many fucking times because I wanted someone to bring up the 100-year-old Native American nuclear physicist. Because I knew the second that
come
up...
Who's trying to arm small countries and non-national armies worldwide.
Yeah.
With nuclear weapons.
Yeah, like...
A thing nuclear physicists love to do.
Yeah.
Like Robert Oppenheimer's famous quote, "Come and get it, boys. Nukes for everyone."
I just wanted that conversation to come up so badly because it's just like, oh, it's such a normal conversation for so long, and they just drop that super Metal Gear sounding thing.
What the fuck is this game? I'm so excited for the video game to start.
Yeah.
It's...
We got something called Devil's House, too, so...
That's good, that's good. Devil's House 2 is my favorite Netflix original. Came out in October. Big hit.
Mm-hmm.
Devil's House 2.
Death to the pigs.
Yeah, fuck those pigs. Which pigs are they talking about? What are the pigs?
I have
Who
no
are
idea.
The pigs? They probably deserve it.
Yeah. Also, that that cassette tape I picked up. The song is called "How About Them Zombies, Eh?"
Do you think Kojima would come on our podcast?
If we tried really hard, maybe. First, we have to become friends with Mads Mikkelsen. That's our in.
Okay. Yeah.
Or if we just know any kind of, like, strangely hunky celebrity. Like, attractive in a strange way. And yeah, Kojima doesn't know them already, that's our in.
Don't compare me to some amateur. I designed it for human control from the beginning. The problem was miniaturizing the posture control.
I like Huey calling Paz an amateur for modifying a Metal Gear to be piloted by a human being. And it's like, how the fuck did Paz do that? she modified a Gundam to be controlled by a human being and knew to put a water buffering in there so that she wouldn't die.
I do love that the Sahelanthropus, like, yeah, anthropoid, thank you, wasn't discovered until after this game is set.
Yep. There are cassette tapes explaining that, too.
Fuck you. No, there are. Stop lying.
There totally
That's too
is.
Dumb.
I think I'll be...
That is too nitpicky and dumb.
Having the AI mounted externally would have been the fastest way to get...
We've heard there's an Afrikaans English interpreter operating somewhere in that
I was listening
area.
To that.
If you extract him, he could be plenty useful for us.
Yeah.
Anyway, I hope I wasn't interrupting some dumbass talking about nerd bullshit. Skullface refused to wait. I want my big robot now. And took Sahelanthropus away from me before I could finish. My big robot is behind door number one or door number two.
Maybe we'll just take a nice break.
Swear to God, if a little bird lands on his nose, I will not know which game we're playing.
Oh my God. Big Boss has to go crash a wedding.
Primavera. Ravioli.
Fucking Seething Crow, look at him.
Wow, he's just garbage.
It's not even like he's really bad at things, he literally has no talent.
Did he just swim to Mother Base?
But, you know what? I think I'm going to make Seething Crow do a mission and prove himself. A weird thing, though, is when you're playing as your soldiers, the game still acts like you are Big Boss. Like, everyone still addresses you as boss. Mm-hmm. Other soldiers will still salute you. Maybe Big Boss is just putting out a message like, hey, this guy's a hotshot because I said so. Everyone, like, respect him. Call him Boss 2.
I think there's just severe face blindness going around the crew.
Maybe, yeah. Yeah, we'll put him close to Mission 8, let him do some other stuff beforehand. And you know what? He's gonna get free reign. He can use any equipment he wants. Spend as much money as you need, buddy. Let's use D-Walker.
You have every chance to succeed, buddy.
Yeah. You can make 3 different loadouts for D-Walker since he has a bunch of different equipment. So you can kind of build him for different needs. This one's kind of more the fuck everybody up thing.
Yeah, I would guess.
But we'll keep him with the kind of stealth-based one. D-Walker is kind of like a all-rounder buddy. Can do a little bit of everything depending on how you build it out.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of the buddy that I personally have used the least. I'm going to try and use it a lot during the LP because he is pretty fun to use. One of the differences between your D-Walker and the ones that you can, like, hijack is that it also has a running mode.
Mm.
Or a driving mode.
Whoa.
Other weapons and items need blueprints from other things to be built. There's some other, like, electric-based things that also need the stun arm blueprint. I guess it's, like, to start as a basis or something? I don't know. It could be a little confusing, is what I'm saying.
Well, just use the stun armor you already have, take it apart, and draw some pictures.
Yeah. Snake could do it. He's an A++ in R&D. Also, D-Walker is really good at doing sweet jumps.
You have 2 objectives. Eliminate the colonel and stop the tank deployment. Counting on you, boss.
You're definitely going to steal the colonel and probably the tanks, right?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Absolutely. He's such a plain-looking dude, God.
Yeah, yeah. But one day, his son, Agent Wilmore, will see...
Seething Crow, in all of his foresight, he really wants this to go well, so he's preparing for every contingency. You don't know why you would need this, but maybe a situation will pop up where you need a man with C4 strapped to his butt.
Uh-oh, time for robot punching.
Unfortunately, the D-Walker is not capable of chaining CQC like Big Boss is. So, what's Big Boss doing? Oh, you know. Look, I found a contingency for this plan!
Here we go, it all comes together. No one is radioing him. This is apparently going as expected.
I don't know about this. Look, maybe I soften it up. Maybe there's like some perfect weak point in tanks where you shoot it and it just instantly blows up.
Yeah,
like throwing a grenade inside of it.
Like you saw The Hobbit, right?
Yeah.
Snake, talk to me.
That ain't Snake.
Snake!
Oh wait, no, that's just Miller calling him, going like, he fucked up!
Snake!
Wake up!
Get out of bed!
Maybe we have to give him a little bit of extra hand-holding. Maybe he needs to equip the chicken hat.
I see.
Yeah. If you die a lot in Metal Gear in the same mission over and over, you're given the chance to wear the chicken hat. It glows in the dark. It's got jiggly googly eyes on it.
Oh my word. Yes, I would like chicken fries with that.
Ooh.
My chunky chicken combo, I will have some chicken fries.
I can't believe Cypher / the Patriot suppressed chicken fries at Burger King for so many years. You'll get caught, and then it'll just act like nothing happened. So, while we're under the help of the chicken hat, I'm just gonna fulton these tanks, thank you very much. For Metal Gear Solid 3, if you went to E3, you could get a can of snake meat.
That's right, I remember this.
Yeah, it was like
the snake meat can.
It was like a Metal Gear Solid 3, like, survival can of snake meat. I don't know if anybody ever ate theirs.
Why wouldn't you eat the snake meat?
I've never been able to find anybody, like, saying, like, oh yeah, I ate this, and this is what it was like. Oh. I wonder how Seething Crow did.
Rejoin Big Boss on his one day off.
Yeah. I mean, he's done a lot of shit. He deserves a day off. He hasn't taken a day off in 9 years.
This means Cypher might be getting wind of our existence. We may need to move more cautiously
existence?
From now on. I just hope this incident has nothing to do with him. I've added the details to your mission list.
Like, I think they know of your existence because, one, they were already tailing Diamond Dogs when Big Boss was still in a coma so that they could capture Miller and interrogate him, which was the whole crux of the first mission.
To kill you?
And there was a jet plane literally following your helicopter!
Our men will be killed the moment the interrogation's complete.
And I am thinking Miller is only emotionally stupid.
Yeah, no, I think he's just dumb. Look, how about you just join our club in the ocean that has an ideology about how we shouldn't have an ideology? Alright! We're all in agreement.
And there are no personal vendettas or wars. Now let me tell you about Cypher. And how they're all worthless pig dogs that should rot in the furnace of hell.
We're only going to be playing this one with one character, and that's just Big Boss, our tactical boy.
Mm-hmm. Getting a lot of mileage out of Big Boss.
Yeah, he's a... I paid attention to earlier videos. It's like, oh, there were several videos where I just kind of skipped Big Boss. So we're using him just a little bit to kind of make up for him taking a break.
Okay.
You got a lead on what's happening with the CFA. Check it on your
Okay, he swallowed the intel he had. Mm-hmm. He immediately gave it as soon as he was on the chopper.
Yeah, and here it is.
Wow, he's a pooper on demand. Incredible skills.
And somewhat surprisingly, this game lets you like start making the stealth camo early on in the game. The squad
is
on its way
to construction camp. Is it really that different from the camo you're in? These aren't your
everyday reinforcements. Whatever's it makes you literally invisible, so. Now.
So not that different, no. Okay.
This is about 90% invisible most of the time. Mm-hmm.
9% more and you will invent the podcast.
It doesn't really matter what it is. As long as you have like a medium-sized object in the road, drivers will stop to examine it.
Mm-hmm. Well, it says so on the bumper sticker. I stop for medium-sized objects.
Yeah, my playthrough here with Big Boss, because I've gone undetected enough and I've been tagging lots of dudes, there aren't just, like, one or two inflatable soldier decoys. Like, half the base is that now.
Well, it's someone's birthday. They went a little wild.
And also, we developed Fultons that are capable of lifting up vehicles and stuff, but that also means we can finally lift these giant containers.
Yes!
It costs 10,000 GMP to airlift one. Kind of pricey, but it's, you know, 750 biological material, whatever that is.
We know what it is. We know what it is.
Yeah.
I expect all the biological material in this game to just be like, children's bones. Do you get it?
Whoa. Skullface is planning to make a Metal Gear out of the bones of children.
And only Hank Hill can stop him. What was that, boys? I don't know.
I haven't done Skullface in so long that I just turned to Hank Hill. That song was too shy in that cassette tape. I'm not gonna let it play, because fuck you, YouTube.
Hank Hill probably could stop Skullface, though. I don't think I'm wrong there.
Yeah.
Just give him a stern talking to.
I mean, would Skullface be scared of Hank Hill automatically due to his propane stuff? Because, I mean, Skullface was burned alive.
Mm-hmm.
he'd be terrified of that clean burn.
The PMC ain't right. Miller is just screaming about how he loves it when his balls stick to his leg. It's the phantom pain.
Oh, he lost one of his balls too, I see.
Yeah.
Oh no.
Refuses a prosthetic in yeah. all cases.
We have a specialist that just makes balls, like... You can have three if you want, Miller. Bullet armadillo.
Grizzly iguana.
Grizzly iguana
rancid
is really good.
Goat! No! Why is the goat rancid? No!
He's had a hard life.
Boss, that man you picked up in Walla Yamasa is a top-notch gunsmith.
Legendary,
got
even.
Of work for him. But it turns out that he's just the apprentice of a so-called legendary gunsmith.
God
damn it!
Now, if
this legendary gunsmith is all he's cracked up to be, we could really use him on our side.
What?
The apprentice gave us the whereabouts of his master. If you've got the time...
The map lies.
Mm-hmm.
Eventually, you'll get to, like, Zeta Gunsmith. ZZ Gunsmith. Gunsmith Zero.
I'm Gunsmith ZX!
Did you know that G Gunsmith has a gun that is a horse?
Whoa! I'll never be able to stop pointing out this fact to everyone I meet! There are many different ways to prove to these soldiers that you are Big Boss. There's more than just wearing the cardboard box. One of them is to just simply get him in a CQC hold. Because they know the grip of their boss.
That's why it's such an important part of training on new mother base.
So something I wanted to bring up, or ask you really, is
sure.
we are.
Do you want to keep doing this game? Is that the question?
No, I feel like the goofiness of Metal Gear still shows up through some of the gameplay and stuff. But it really does feel like. It feels like my fun uncle had something really bad happen to him, and he's never recovering from it now. Like, he's not fun to be around anymore? I don't know.
No, he's clearly the same guy, but it's just not the same.
Yeah.
Even so. He's so desperate to be loved.
Yeah, it's... I will say I do like the return of Huey in this, although we...
Actually, yeah, I do like... Huey's not fun, but I love all of his tapes because he's such a little snivelly jerk.
Yeah, he is, I do kind of wish this idea with Huey of what his character is now was a little more, like, connected or foreshadowed to how he was in Peace Walker, but I feel like he can still easily connect Because it's like, you know, he still basically just went, oh, nuclear weapons suck. I'm never going to make that. Except for you, boss. I'll make one for you.
Huey is the younger brother in A Christmas Story, just saying, come on, guys, wait up. Come, please.
Yeah.
Guys. And then you remember that he's probably at fault for everything that happened.
Yeah.
Very, very probably.
Yeah, but there's more with Huey later on, and I really do think it's some of the best stuff story-wise in the game, just because I like what they did with his character. I just like that it differentiates him from Otacon, because he is just kind of Otacon beta
they
version.
They weren't particularly different in Peace Walker.
Yeah. I like that he hasn't mentioned his son once.
That's how you know he's a real piece of shit.
Otacon has already been born by this by the date of this game. He's like 3 or 4 years
old,
I think.
None of his pleading to, like, come on, help me out, trust me, I would like to speak to my son, it never comes up.
Yeah.
Whenever you're, like, grabbing a cassette tape, do you ever get the sense that, like, a guard in there was just listening to their tunes before you stole their tunes?
Yeah.
I do like the idea of one of them reporting back after an infiltration mission, just in tears, because that... They stole Michael. They're like looking over all the MIA. There's no one named Michael. No, Michael and Jermaine and Tito, the whole Jackson 5 were stolen.
Why does the big boss have a talking boat?
Well, because Huey would design it. And do you want that? Do you really want that?
Okay, that's true. That would probably be for the worse, honestly.
That boat would have depth charges that spread uranium through the sea. For no reason.
And Huey,
just for fun.
And Huey would talk about how it's an extremely good idea.
It's so good. You know, boss, there are so many species of fish that haven't even been discovered. And the best thing we can do for science is to make them all extinct before they're discovered and described.
Yeah.
So that way our percentage goes up.
And, also, I imagine once some like actual consequences happen, Huey would immediately turn around and say, Big Boss, this is all your fault for telling me to make this.
It's about the prisoner you extracted from the central base camp. It seems that he's not the legendary gunsmith either. Just another one of his apprentices.
Fuck really you!
Yeah. We got another photo, so it's been a while. Let's visit Paz. Remember Paz? She's in this game. Hey, you know what? Remember the man on fire, everybody? No? Oh, that's because he hasn't been in the game since episode 3 of this Let's Play. Episode 35! Where is the man on fire? Is he a character? What happened to him?
Yeah, maybe he could be talking to Skullface.
Oh,
does he talk?
Who knows? Hey, everybody. Remember Ishmael?
I do remember Ishmael.
Remember what was up with that shit, huh? Who cares? Like, right now, one of the big plot threads is, like, this weird disease keeps coming up.
Yes, yes.
And I think that stuff is interesting whenever they hint at it, it's like, whoa, like, a weird disease, what's this about?
Glowy lung syndrome, yes.
How can this tie into any of this stuff, let alone the greater, like, Metal Gear plot? But it just feels weird that, like, if they're gonna leave that be, like, a little thread always dangling, that they wouldn't have, like, another thing to focus on. Hey!
Oh, you have to throw that guy off the platform now.
He turned his back on America.
He really has been through hell.
How?
No, you have to shoot him.
How?
For saying you fucked your mom.
How dare you talk about my mother like that, frigid rooster? An ochre badger. You're the worst of all.
Where's Professor Galvez anyway?
Oh.
I'm sorry, Snake. My head
Paz,
hurts.
It's a long story, and I'll cut to the chase. He shot his hand at me. And so I shot him with a bullet.
Now that I say it out loud, it does seem a kind of overkill. Not exactly even retribution.
Like, Zadornov didn't even have, like, an explosive rocket hand. He just shot his hand out with two of his fingers extended out like he was gonna try and poke his eyes out.
When we're done recording, can you tell me what happens if we beat Cypher? What the greater world stakes are?
If you really want to know, I can, yeah.
I mean, maybe that's sort of the point, right?
Yeah.
That, like, you're doing this huge, giant thing. Like, you are upsetting the balance of world powers. Look at what you have built.
Yeah.
Look at what you and your robot hand have wrought here just for petty personal vengeance. And you do not care about what happens to the world. And okay, you as the character don't, but I, the player, sure fucking do. I want to know.
Yeah.
I deserve to know.
It's, I could tell you.
I don't know.
Maybe wait. I promise.
The people deserve to hear me find out.
Yeah. I will say that once Skullface's grand plot is truly revealed, you're going to go, what the fuck? It's kind of out there, and I do kind of like it, even if it's kind of dumb as shit. So in many previous videos, we have talked about Big Boss and Master Miller having a naked fight in the shower.
Fight. That's one word. It's one thing you could call it.
So this is an event that is brought up in Peace Walker in one of Paz's like secret diary tapes you can find after you beat the game. This was just an event that was referenced. You never saw it happen in a cutscene or anything.
They wanted to be able to sell the game in stores.
That's true. Look, they totally could have had weird floating clouds of steam over their junk, right? In Japan, there's a market for drama CDs. So basically, like, even stuff like fucking Mega Man gets drama CDs, where it's just like they get some voice actors. It's just like a radio drama or something. It usually has like maybe some promo art or something, and it's like a really cheap way to like make a buck and also like expand like side story stuff in a lot of properties.
Yeah.
Metal Gear does
audio
it.
Audio drama is good. It's good.
Yeah. There was one for Metal Gear Solid Peace Walker in Japan called Kazuhira no Blues. It is mostly an extended retelling of how Master Miller met Big Boss. Like, there's already a tape in Peace Walker where Miller talks about how they met. And it's just a very extended version of that. But there was also a reenactment of the shower fight that Paz mentions. And earlier in 2018, both David Hayter and Robin Atkin Downs decided to just dub it just for the hell of it.
Oh, and who does David Hayter play?
Oh, I don't know anymore.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm surprised they couldn't get the real Big Boss for this.
I know, right? Kept you waiting, huh? But anyways, let's take a listen to this new dub that just got put out.
The sauna is popular with the staff, you know.
Mm-hmm.
You wait until it gets...
I feel like they're going to try to sell me a sauna at the end. Like, there's going to be a 1-800 number I can dial to get my own sauna.
Slipped? Armadillo? Guy's built like a tank. He's got perfect posture. I've never seen him fall.
This is so weird to... Yeah. One, because it's weird to hear David Hayter after a while, but also because Big Boss is being so fucking conversational.
Maybe he just got dizzy from all the steam.
I see. So the sauna made him fall, huh?
Who localized this? Boss. I don't know.
Boss?
Is there anything you want to tell me?
I think you're overdoing it there, boss.
This is good.
I'm bleeding. Hell yeah.
This is not a competition.
All right.
Gaz. Are you popular? Look, I'm not going to control everyone's love affairs. That's your responsibility. You're a free man.
Thank you, boss. My actual boss.
Soap play, huh? Are you still blaming the soap? The steam?
It was just a...
Talk.
I'm sorry. It wasn't planned.
Wasn't planned? Armadillo saw you both, didn't he? Saw you with his girlfriend. And I'd say he was pretty surprised to find you both in here. Armadillo. So proud. Built like a tank. But then...
Perfect posture. Finish the thought.
What the hell were you thinking? Whatever happened to chivalry?
Snake!
To think I even have to give you this sermon.
Speaking of sermons, boss, I need you to sign off on the non-denominational chapel going up on the new strut.
Dolphin, Puma, do you want me to beat you for all of them too?
I didn't do anything.
You son of a bitch. I'm gonna beat
you. It was all over the pants stuff, I swear.
God. I wish it was somehow in Peace Walker, like in just the graphic novel style, like the rest of the cutscenes. It would be incredible. Put in a QuickTime event. The cutscenes in that game had QuickTimes.
I really wish they filmed this and they were actually beating the hell out of each other.
Oh man, that would be good.
Think about it seriously, Kaz. It's either women or us.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
There's like no subtext there.
There is none.
It's just all out there.
Yeah.
You're gonna clean the sauna for the next year.
That's the punishment for fucking everyone's girlfriend on the base.
There's the shower scene. I'm happy they dubbed it. This also reminds me that David Hayter has just been like doing random fan projects where he voices Snake again. And also, he's on that one website where you can pay, like, celebrities to just, like...
Cameo, right?
Yeah, Cameo, where they can just, like, do custom messages for people for, like, $20 or whatever. David Hayter is on there, and you can just have him say whatever the fuck you want as Snake. For not that much money, either, honestly. Like, I'm tempted, but I don't know what to make him say.
Yeah.
A commander murdering his former men. That's what this boils down to.
Yeah, but you could do the same. You're just choosing to keep the people you find in the wilderness alive.
Yeah. And also, yeah, the operation boundary for this mission is a diamond.
Ah.
Because there's a diamond mine in this mission. So, this is a big mission. And so this will be a mission where we see the return of all three snakes.
Hooray!
Although, this mission is going to be spread across two episodes, so you're not going to be seeing Venom Snake this episode. Wish we could still have that sauna boss, but after that fight, we just proved that none of us are ready to have one yet.
Not ready to have it, yeah. It's also why there's no cats. Someone forgot to feed Nuke.
Yeah.
Putting the target to sleep doesn't count as eliminating them. Neither does knocking them out.
Alright, I just wish Miller would realize at this point, it's like, oh, you're gonna Fulton them. Okay. I'll get the applications and all the paperwork ready.
I notice he never gets snippy when you Fulton the Jeep. You think maybe he just wants to start a used car lot out there in the Seychelles?
Maybe. Maybe Miller's getting tired of the whole PF business, and he just wants to try his hands at something else. Start from scratch, you know? How would Vapor Snake handle this? I mean, it's not very hard to get inside the base. You can just kind of walk in from the sides and nobody will notice. And it's not even that hard to find the guy. But when he's in the middle of the base, it's kind of hard to take him out. Hoping he'll die from being annoyed by all these empty magazines, I think.
Yeah, maybe he has a heart condition.
Yeah.
Enough that he can be irritated to death.
What are you planning on doing, boss? Putting the target to sleep doesn't count as eliminating
I that. Love that Miller thinks a man out. Being smushed and then launched into the air by a tank is somebody that is getting put to sleep.
Well, yeah, again, in the veterinary sense.
Yeah, I guess so.
Target confirmed dead. Five targets remain.
Also, no one cares about the giant golden tank that is in the middle of their base.
Yeah. If you drop one of your vehicles into the mission area, like, you don't have to refulton it to keep it. Like, the instant you leave the mission area, it just automatically gets fultoned. It's great. What? You were supposed to be distracted by being horny, mister. Oh, boy.
How dare you? How dare you be less horny than expected?
My tactics are being ruined by these men not being horny. Might as well get in my golden tank. But yeah, that's a thing.
I think this says something about America. Just not sure.
Maybe.
Why.
I don't know.
Chicolobwe uranium might have been used in the Hiroshima and Nagasaki bombs, too. Just hearing its name is like seeing all the phantoms of the war rise up to haunt us.
Ah, crap.
But all the uranium's dried up, and the mine's been closed for years.
So someone reopened it.
Right.
Zero, like I said, they don't know how to drive around things. So they might get stopped, but eventually they'll find a way through, just through other means. I do gotta say, though, for a game series that so lovingly renders butts pretty much all the time, a lot of the guards in this game don't really have much of a butt. Maybe there's a hidden stat somewhere that determines their butt.
This is the beginning of the end, and then Smash is really going to seal it. The end of the butts. No more butts.
I will say, like, when people were like, oh no, they ruined Snake's ass in Smash in previews and stuff. It does seem that, like, they did a second pass on his model because his butt is better.
Yeah.
In the final game, Snake's butt is a lot better.
While we're talking about Kojima and his celebrity friends.
Yeah.
Something that I've, harped on a little bit is how weird I think Jeff Keighley and Kojima's relationship is.
Yes, it's weird!
It's weird. It's weird. It's weird because, let me tell you why I think it's weird. It's weird because if you are friends with Kojima, the whole world knows he will not shut up about you and how much he loves you.
Yeah.
I have never seen him do that for Jeff Keighley.
No.
It is so one-sided.
It's weird. It's really weird.
That's an enemy gun.
I know, Ocelot. I absolutely agree that the relationship with Keighley and Kojima is very strange and feels very one-sided. Also, I want to bring up that...
You get the sense, at least I do, that, like, Keighley would name all of his children after Hideo Kojima.
Yeah.
Who would not even notice.
Yeah. Also, these.
He would be like, Jeff, I don't know any Jeffs in America. I'm sorry. I don't.
Yeah. Also, this fence is really sturdy and the tank can't knock it over for some reason. It wiggles, but it won't break.
They should make the whole base out of that.
Right? Impenetrable. Speaking of Jeff Keighley, though, I also want to bring up that fairly recently, we're recording this in January of 2019. Fairly recently, Kanye West tweeted, yo, I heard that Hideo Kojima is going to be in New York, and I really got to talk to him. And Jeff Keighley immediately responded to him on Twitter, hey, I can get this arranged. What's going to happen? Yeah. Don't do this.
Yeah, that's such a weird thing to do. Like, unless Kojima was like, yeah, that sounds good. Hey, my good buddy Jeff, who I never talk about, unlike my good buddy Norman and my good buddy Guillermo and my good buddy... Mads.
Yeah.
Because it's not what it sounds like. It sounds like I'm just going to shoot you this guy's phone number who may not know how I have it.
Yeah.
Look at him. Look at that butt. Oh, my goodness.
There he comes.
Darling, there's hedgehogs in this game. You have to see. There's hedgehogs. Come here.
I'm coming.
Okay. They have real, they're really wiggly.
Yeah, I think this buddy needs to be my friend.
Don't shoot the hedgehog.
He's asleep.
He's asleep. The hedgehog is going to,
look,
to
he's,
the...
he's breathing.
The cute animal zoo on a oil platform.
He just pulled me over so he could shoot the hedgehog in front of me.
I didn't know he was going to shoot. I could have guessed he was going to shoot the hedgehog.
He's fine. Actually. He's going to a zoo. Oh, Jesus.
He's going to make so many friends. There's bears and rams. Well, there's just the one bear. So many birds that are going to be friends of the hedgehog.
I'm really not happy right now.
Okay.
But yeah, that whole thing with Kanye West was weird. I also have not met Jeff Keighley, but I know people who do. because I used to work at Volition, and I had some friends who worked there while Jeff Keighley visited for, like, some Saints Row 3 thing. And they told me he was a little strange. Like, he was nice and well-meaning, but basically when he wasn't recording something, he was talking to no one and just constantly checking his Twitter and responding to fans.
I mean, that's the life, man.
I guess it is,
That's the hustle.
So, you know, I'm shooting this dude. The guy
behind,
the guy behind him was looking right at me. The instant I popped out of the box, he did a 180. And now, like, I thought this guy, like, oh, he didn't see me because, like, he just had really narrow vision or something. But what's happened, actually, is I don't know what exactly I did, but this chain of events has rendered me invisible. Men are confused and they know something is wrong. They don't know I'm here, and if they walk too close to me, they get fucking held up. Hey, buddy, come over here. Something just shot you in the helmet. What's going on? Oh, I don't know. This guy just fell asleep for no reason. Weird. Oh,
Vapor Snake's psyche has been rendered.
Hands up, motherfucker! Don't move!
I think plot is about to happen.
Whoa.
I have this feeling that plot is going to happen.
You might be right. There's an air of plot about.
Bingo. You know what to do.
Murder those kids, boss.
You take that. You'll need it to pay the ferryman across the River Styx.
Oh.
Heaven. Or hell.
No, there's another.
Utter heaven.
Miller, you always forget it's about that. Lost. We called it this for a reason. Because it sounds cool as shit. Yay, I got my own kids.
He did it. He did it. Now you'll become the greatest father.
Woo! Can't wait to make him shoot guns.
Your code name is Big Pops.
Large father.
Doesn't look like he can walk. You still gonna help him?
It's generally how it works.
I love Miller just going like, that one can't walk. Are you sure? Just leave him. You got enough.
I think he's less worthy of human dignity.
What the fuck, Miller?
This is the guy with missing fucking limbs.
Yeah. So you might be thinking, like, why the fuck do I gotta go to some place all the way over here on the map to, like, rescue the kids? Can't I just Fulton them like any other living, breathing thing?
It works for bears.
Yeah. So if you try to do it with children, this is what you get.
You can't Fulton extract children.
Uh-huh.
Boss, a child couldn't withstand the shock of Fulton extraction.
Well, it's true, because their heads aren't finished. You gotta support the neck.
We'll look into developing a child extraction device. But for now, you'll have to get them to the RV yourself.
They're like 6 months old, right? I'm not good with kids. I want to ask a question.
Yeah.
But I'm afraid it will spoil what you have coming.
Uh-huh.
I'm gonna ask anyway, can you get around that by Fultoning a Jeep that happens to have children in it?
Come on, kids, get in the fun bus. Look, it's called Fat Dogs. Come on, kids. What? These kids don't want to get in the Jeep of their own volition, so I'm gonna have to give them a little bit of a nap time. Just relocate them myself. Right, here you go.
Haven't we covered enough of how, the ways this game makes it clear that Big Boss is the bad guy? Do you have to, as the player, literally kick children?
Oh, no. Off you go, kids.
They seem pretty chill. And they are definitely wearing their seatbelts, huh?
Okay, bye.
Target extracted. Anyone else?
But, hey, kids, stop. Oh, and also, you can tell the kids to go and stop, but you have to be close enough for them to hear you. Once you're far enough away, they just... They won't react to your commands.
Mm-hmm. Reminds me of my own kids.
All 12 of them.
Yeah, the only command I have is shut up. I'm making the internet love me.
Be quiet and I'm recording my Let's Plays.
Also, go eat gushers. Those are the only two things they've ever heard from me.
Venom Snake, who we haven't seen for this mission yet, we're just gonna go in there with a tank and quiet. And our ninja in our Ninja Turtle armor.
Yes, Mr. Chonk is here to save the day.
Oh, we're also gonna do the mission backwards, because he can do that.
So you're gonna put the kids in jail.
Yeah. I'm gonna find them running about. Hello.
You get bullet time in a tank!
Just juggle that dude. There's basically one design path for you to go through, and it's designed in a way where they really want you to get caught.
Well, fuck that.
The like planned experience for this part is to sneak through most of it and then get caught near the end, so you have to defend the kids when you're close to the helicopter. It's totally possible to not get caught. It's just very stacked against you.
I defend children every day. I never stop posting. I am always extremely online for the children.
I'm woke for the kids. I don't know if I would ever really want actual, like, remakes of Metal Gear 1 and 2, but I do feel it would probably be pretty incredible as long as they didn't modernize the really goofy bits too much, because I still want to have to collect chocolate to melt Big Boss's face. Oh, excuse me. No, you have to pick up chocolate because the chemicals...
For the acid on the ground. Yeah,
yeah. The acid that, like, instantaneously melts you into the floor. When you get to this point in the mission, like, a ton of guards spawn behind you searching for the kids because they realize at this point that they're gone. It's scripted, it always happens, and it's like a good six dudes who are, like, almost immediately behind you. That's one of the ways they really try to screw you over right at the end. And they also just, the helicopter's been flying around. Another scripted thing, they just make the helicopter, land, like, right in front of you at this part. Yeah, it's, really funny seeing the evolution and how Big Boss handles children just from Peace Walker to this game.
I mean, the only child was Chico.
Yeah, Chico and... Well, he thought Paz was a child, at least.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He thought she was a teen.
Yeah. She's actually a 3,000-year-old dragon spirit inhabiting the body of a little girl, so it's, you know. Since we killed everybody in the mine, we were able to, with no trouble, evacuate all the children. You don't have to sneak or anything. You just walk to the helicopter, because they don't spawn more guys if you kill them all. Thanks, Quiet.
Yeah, yeah, I'll take credit for that.
Yeah,
sure.
Mm-hmm. I mean, look, I was the one who hired her, so I get the credit.
Yeah, absolutely. Also, give me a $50 million bonus.
Everyone on Mother Base is fired. Oh, speaking of Big Boss firing dudes, though, remember in Peace Walker when you would fire people, Big Boss would literally say, "You're fired"?
No, but that sounds... I'm not going to say it didn't happen. Okay.
But, yeah, Big Boss had a goofy voice clip where you fired just soldiers.
Just to be clear, you know that Snart Cookie and I are different people, right?
I know. I mean, you saw it, though. Okay. I thought you might remember.
I saw it, but...
But, yeah, Big Boss, when you fired people, he'd go, "You're fired!" That doesn't happen in this game, but if you dig through the files of the game, there is a voice clip of Kiefer Sutherland saying that. Child times five!
Child times five!
Hell yeah! Also, yeah, ooh, rescuing the kids gets you a key item called Child's Reward, or Children's Reward, and it's just blueprints to make a squirt gun.
Hell yes.
So later on, we'll make a squirt gun to fuck around with.
Never liked kids. Especially ones with guns.
So I will beat them. That's how much I don't like kids.
See, kids are natural. No. He's no natural.
He cannot defeat me, a 30-year-old man!
There's no room for angels in our heaven.
You're my angel.
God, I need a smoke.
Woo, that was a lot of kid rescuing.
Yeah, just keep smoking until they're 18, and then there's no ethical dilemma.
All right, here's a gun. You gotta take out this tank unit. By the way, we still have one more mission left for rescuing the legendary gunsmith yet again. Here he is.
So we've captured all of his ironworking orphans. And yeah. This is the final gunsmith.
Good. We're done with them. We're done with the gunsmiths.
Yet again.
Yet again. So there's an upgrade I got forever ago. They haven't used too much yet, and that is the speaker on the Walkman. So there is a couple different cassette tapes that'll do this, but one of the ones we got is Love Deterrence, which you pick up from the first mission when you're rescuing Miller. And so when you play that on the speaker, they'll remember hearing that song back from Peace Walker, and it'll lure them to you.
Fantastic.
Still a couple other ways to prove that you're a big boss to them. But this is actually probably the easiest, most convenient one, because they can hear it from very far away. So even if you don't know where they are, if you just walk around for a little bit, they'll just follow you.
You don't even have to do anything.
Yeah, it's very easy.
Who took this? Strangelove? Maybe when she rubbed that sunscreen on me. Oh, I'm trying not to remember it.
Yeah, that's probably for the best.
You know,
yeah.
Despite her quirks, Dr. Strangelove is a good person.
I wouldn't call that a quirk when she, like everyone else, believed you were a minor.
My head. It hurts.
Also, she is complicit in trying to start a nuclear war.
Yeah, that too.
There's that.
Oh, and also, we're good enough friends with Quiet now that we can make the Guilty Butterfly, which is a Trank sniper rifle. And also, we're good enough friends with Quiet now that suddenly she just starts doing this in the helicopter. What the fuck?
Tell you what, I'm not good enough friends with anybody for that to happen in my life.
So. She's doing this now because our bond, like, has gone up with her, right? You would think that would be like, oh, you're at, like, 80 out of 100 points. We're at 20 out of 100 points! That's what she does at 20 points out of 100 for friendship! What? Oh. What the fuck?
Like, pilots do not fucking care. They like, are over it.
You seeing this fucking shit, Pequod? What the hell? Anyways, let's customize some guns.
Yeah, let's make a dang gun.
Oh, man. Big Boss hasn't developed a ton of guns, so there aren't a ton of optional parts, but we've made the very loud Trank sniper rifle, and we can just slap a suppressor on it now. Hooray!
I'm gonna be laughing for the next 29 minutes.
No, yeah, I don't blame you.
It's so dumb.
It's really stupid. Oh, man.
Okay, so this was a promotional tie-in with the Ghost in the Shell movie.
Absolutely.
I see. Okay.
Yeah. Can't wait.
He's the one who was investigating.
Can't wait for that Battle Angel Alita DLC.
Oh, no.
Gonna make Miller's eyes huge.
This is actually a pretty simple mission.
The target's man should be somewhere around there.
After the last couple of missions being like really big, like hour-long affairs, this one's like easy to complete in like 15, 20 minutes. You know, we're supposed to follow the guy. We dropped in from a different spot than Big Boss did. But it's been a while. We rescued kids. That was stressful. We had to buckle them all in. They were all rowdy, so I had to kick them to sleep. Let's just take a long smoke break. I'm glad the horse is so patient.
Yeah, it's just a boys' night out with you and your horse, bud.
Also, our Phantom cigar has been upgraded enough that you can pass a full 24 hours with one smoke.
But why? Why would you want to do that?
Whenever you take too much of a too much of a smoke. It's just kind of forget what we're doing. Just leave her horse by.
Oh no.
He'll take care of himself. No. He's a wild animal. He'll revert back to his instincts if I leave him. Hopefully.
He's waiting for you to put in the next movie, but now it's just gonna replay Bad Boys 2 again.
Oh no.
But they're probably afraid of me. I'm going to throw weapons at them. So they know it's okay.
Boss, get down. That's an enemy gunship. Stay low and crawl along the ground. That should enable you to sneak past.
They don't take kindly to you throwing grenades at zebras.
Yes. The park rangers here are really, really uptight.
Each animal, once you put in, like, a couple of them, that's the limit to how many you'll see in the zoo. Like, most of the time it's just, like, two per animal.
Mm-hmm.
So even when you have a full zoo, it's never, like, bustling, and I just really wanted a super crowded zoo. Just a, just a
herds
fucking...
roving.
Yeah, just a swirling swarm of every animal mixed up in just one giant zoo in the middle of the ocean. I'm really glad that...
That's an enemy gunship.
Ocelot, I fucking know about what helicopters are. Good lord. I'm really glad you don't have to, like, keep a specific distance to these guys, or else they just, like, vanish and it's game over.
Mm-hmm.
They can just be... you can be on the opposite side of the map and it doesn't matter. Oh, another thing is, I've shown that trick before with the cardboard box where you could fool guys into thinking you're a soldier just by putting the poster on your box.
Yes.
Because there are different soldiers here. They're from, you know, the PFs. There's a different poster you have to wear for these guys. Otherwise, they're not convinced. If you just put on the poster for the Russians, they're not convinced and they'll shoot you. Also, there's this weird cassette over here. I mean, this weird noise, and after all this smoking, there's just some type of weird tone in the sound that doesn't go well with the state I'm in. I don't like it. I do not like the sound. Where am I? What is this? How do I get out of here? Please help me. I was fucking here already.
I'm gonna go back to looking at Quiet's ass, okay? I'll catch up with you later.
Oh, what is this? Oh boy. What the fuck is that?
204863.
The only me is me. Are you sure the only you is you?
This music playing from the stereo in this base in Metal Gear is a song that plays from the radio in PT, the little demo thing to tease Silent Hills, the other game Kojima was making at Konami before it got canceled and he got let go. This is the test, like, tone video they made. Look, they reused Shigo's model.
Nothing ever goes right for that kid. Fuck.
Yeah. This was a tone video they made to say, oh, this is kind of what we want PT to look like before they even made PT and started working on Silent Hills. But yeah, this is not the only reference to PT in this game. There's another one later. Ooh. I don't like that, though. I'm burning this.
Good thing there's some fuel resources. Yeah.
Yeah. But yeah, the tape itself in the song is called 204863, that random string of numbers that the guy in the radio says.
Now, if are any of your recruits named Jareth?
I don't need think to so. Know. If they are, I'm throwing him into the fucking ocean, I think. But all that footage of PT, I captured that myself. I am one of the people that still has PT on their PlayStation 4, and I am never deleting it because you cannot download it anymore after Konami took it off the store. This was
put
like a secret.
Put them all in the van, and then felt in the Jeep. Save balloons.
You're right. Should have done that. This is just like a secret, like, seminar or something, like, just recruitment. Conference.
So, you want to kill people for money, but you're tired of being in Africa. Imagine a mastodon, the tallest thing on Earth, just shouting, step on me, and all of the other animals are like, how? What are you talking about?
It's the thing I've wanted most in life because it's not possible.
Masochistic mastodon is just is my favorite kink positive tragicomic webcomic.
I've always been the biggest, but yet I yearn for something even bigger than me. We've also developed the rocket arm.
Hell yes.
So if you take a look at our arm, it's a different color. It's gray. The rocket arm is incredible. Go into first person here and fucking fire it.
Rocket piece!
It's literally just rocket piece. It's so good. But yeah, you can steer the arm. It has a pretty decent range.
Found the guy.
Yep. If you look below the rocket arm in the bottom right, there's that little meter. That's the fuel for the arm.
Oh.
But even if you run out of fuel, it'll still keep going and knock dudes out if it hits them. It just goes in a straight line. On top of just being normal decoys, they also attract dudes by making noise, and specifically, it's just Kiefer Sutherland doing bad line reads.
You're pretty good.
So it's people are attracted to them just to see, wait, really?
Yeah.
Really? Everybody get a load of this.
Yeah. By the way, everybody get a load of this. Welcome to your new job. I love it. You can drive the arm into yourself.
Yes.
It doesn't do, it just does stamina damage though. It doesn't take your health away or anything.
In that moment, it does make the "you're pretty good" sound sarcastic and therefore fitting.
Yeah.
You're pretty good.
Very good.
You're running room. Catch your way. There you go.
I love the active decoys. They're so dumb.
Catch me in designated survivor on CBS.
What do helicopters do if you fire your rocket arm at them? Like, it's open. I can drive the arm inside the helicopter. Turns out, helicopters don't like it. They don't like rocket arms being inside them. They hate it. They get very suspicious. But the good thing is, helicopters are also distracted by inflatable decoys. But now there's a helicopter that's really mad. It's going to be hard to run away because he's going to see me. I just need some kind of galaxy brain getaway, like Fultoning myself.
Yes.
Goodbye. Cannibal Gecko.
Oh. Yes, I would like your car insurance, yes. Why don't you come over to my place and talk about it?
He said something else that caught my attention. The ZRS are trying to kill some old man. How did one old man get that kind of attention?
Oh, just you wait.
Oh, boy.
The 100-year-old Native American.
Nuclear physicist.
Nuclear physicist.
God.
Nuclear scientist.
Nuclear scientist.
Yeah.
Well,
oh, boy.
Nuclear science is physics, so I don't feel bad.
About those walker gear spreading all over Africa, Huey's got an idea for a counterweapon.
Put a stick in the wheels.
It's a variable multi-legged team.
God damn it, Huey!
A true battle gear!
Cause I'm having deja vu here. I don't like him any more than you.
I really like this cutscene for that bit. This.
What comes next? Selling nuclear weapons in the open? Making them public property?
Hell yeah. Socialize the nukes.
Right.
Seize the means of annihilation.
Hello. But yeah, you can come to this hangar to see, like, what's going on with the battle gear. Unfortunately, I wish you could, like, talk to Huey, but he's always in some section that is unreachable.
Mm-hmm.
How the fuck did you get up there, Huey?
Now he's just showing off with the robot legs, I swear.
I also wish there was, like, some kind of Easter egg for, like, tranking him or something, but you can't even pull your gun out in this room. Illegal.
What? What?
Right? It's weird. You can shoot Ocelot. What's going on there, Huey? Are you mad that you miss your child, your son?
My what? Oh, right, him.
I love that. I mean, you know, there haven't been too many cutscenes with Huey yet since we rescued him. But I just love that he has never mentioned his son once yet. Oh, I miss my son. Oh.
He'd be like, what, 8, 10, something like that?
I forget.
but like a fully formed human being.
Yeah,
with like interests and vocabulary.
Yeah, at this point, Otacon can totally say, like, speak full sentences and shit. Like,
the client has given us the last of their diamonds in return. Go get Shibani out of there, boss. Whatever Cypher's up to in the region.
You're so nice to these kids to let them keep the diamonds.
Right? Only one landing zone for this mission.
But not nice enough to do a job pro bono.
No, absolutely not. Like, Miller will always get paid.
There's a very finely drawn line.
Yeah. Miller has some weird ethics.
It's like, hey, you can come live with us, and also, these are your diamonds now.
Yeah.
Oh, you want us to do something? These aren't your diamonds anymore. That's the end of that, kid.
Maybe that was Miller trying to teach them a lesson or something.
Let me teach you the value of an uncut conflict diamond.
I mean, you know, Miller is pretty fucked up.
You know, when you start running low on CP, like Miller's gonna ask, you know, what you think D horse's stud fees would be. Boss, how much is that horse's sperm worth?
That ain't good.
Huh. All right.
Oh, yep. Digging the graves and everything, huh, guys?
Uh-huh. Cool.
Oh.
Oh, okay. You can take it.
It's fine. It's fine. None of these guys committed this specific war crime. Yeah, that is a little thing that is, I feel like, few people know about. Because it's not like you interrogate any guard in this base and they'll say that line related to the plot of this mission. It's that one specific guy who will say it.
Huh. Okay.
Yeah, so I feel like most people probably have no idea about that.
So am I correct to assume that would be the skull unit that did the...
Yeah, most likely. In fact, yeah, mission 10, when we were rescuing Malik in the Big Boss playthrough, we listened in on the interrogation of Malik, and that guy was asking him who burned a whole village down. A lot of foreshadowing from updates half a year ago. Or more.
And unlike their day shooting junkyard rifles out of beat-up pickup trucks,
hell yeah.
The CFA now supplies them with the latest gear from the West. On top of that, they've been combat trained by the South African Army.
I remember when the President of the United States called Nelson Mandela a terrorist.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. The 80s.
Yeah.
Zaire is still a dictatorship under President Mobutu.
Also, it's still called Zaire.
Yeah. Yep.
EPFs expand the war zone, and more conflicts erupt in a continuous chain reaction. Sounds like our kind of work. Mother base could grow by leaps and bounds.
Ocelot is just listening and stroking his chin. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
All this terrible shit sounds like a good way to make some money. Cool.
The angry one has a point.
Yes.
But if only we could make sure that all guns only worked for the people we wanted to shoot them.
Yeah.
Gonna have to work on that part.
Yeah, it might be a couple decades, but I'm sure we'll figure it out. Hey, everybody, remember when Blackwater literally had an Xbox 360 Kinect game made for them? That was pretty fucked up.
Yeah.
It's also a really bad game.
Well,
I mean, it's also a Kinect game, so no surprise there, but
yeah,
it's just real fucked up.
I'm imagining, like, okay, you've got your zoo struts. They have to put up little info boards, like a zoo does. You learn about the animal. Like, here's everything you know about a zebra. Here's everything you need to know about that bear. And then you get to ones for the birds. It's like, I don't fucking know.
Oh.
The one person I knew who knew birds, she's gone.
Yeah.
Wings, they got them.
Yeah.
They're definitely on there.
They got beaks.
What's the different shape of the beak mean? It means it's a different bird. What the fuck are you asking me for?
I'm just wondering, like, do you think Cecile ever just wonders, like, I wonder what happened to Miller and all those people 9 years later, not knowing that, like, Miller's missing half his fucking limbs, and her friend Big Boss, who was so cheerful before, was in a 9-year coma and doesn't speak anymore, and she goes dead. And Paz has amnesia. Like, if she came back there, she'd be like, oh my fucking god. Also, I always...
There's a guy. I found a guy.
I always get spooked by that specific decoy. He's just right there, and you just... You're not gonna see him until... Oh, a wild dog! Get off of me! Previous update, I talked about how there was some... There's another PT reference in this game. It's, this boombox, the stereo.
State police say the string of domestic homicides appears... 20483.
Yeah, this radio is playing the same stuff that plays in the radio in PT. It plays multiple different things from the radio from PT. It seems a bit random, depending... Like, it just selects a certain thing to play every time you pick the mission. So sometimes you get, like, the stuff like the weird bloody paper bag says. Sometimes you just get the stuff from the radio. It's neat.
Okay, you say it seems random, but yeah, if you checked what color your controller is lit up...
Oh, shit.
...compared to...
I didn't. All right, this seems a lot more Devil's House to me. There's just a massive streak of blood leading to a door. That seems pretty Devil's House to me.
In the mission with the PT tape, cool.
Yeah. Yep, that's Devil's House. You got a real devil-y house here. Don't like it. But yeah. Like with the beginning of the game.
It moved. What the fuck? No. No, I don't like this at all. Ugh. Oh, I don't like this. Ugh. You're not a doctor. Ugh. You're definitely not.
Well, I don't know. He's an A++ in medicine.
I think that just means he's taken more medicine than most living people.
He's full of pills.
So now we figured out what to do with both ends of a headset.
I mean, I know it's your robot hand, but still don't touch that. Alright, what's behind curtain number two?
What is that?
By the way, in the very scary room with all these people hooked up to radios, there's also a place here where you can farm picking up hamsters to get infinite heroism. Whoop.
Hey, hey, it's the bad guy.
Long time no see. The bad guy's here. Hello?
Oh, I'm not sure that's the bad guy. It's hard to tell with the mask.
Burn with the rest of them.
Hey!
Oh, shit!
Hey!
Oh, shit!
Everybody's
it's
here.
It's my dude!
Remember him, everybody, from, like, 9 months ago?
It's like that, that pale orc from the Hobbit movies, and the Balrog had a kid, which means my fanfic is canon now.
Yeah.
You don't gotta tell me twice, bro.
I'll say, time for a boss fight against the man on fire. This was a boss fight that I was originally pretty meh on, but upon replaying it a bunch, I really like it now.
Yeah.
Particularly because there are so many different ways to complete this boss fight.
I'm sure there are.
But yeah, like in the cutscenes from the beginning of the game, don't shoot him a lot because he'll counterattack by shooting the bullets back at you. Also, if you're on fire, rolling puts the fire out quicker. So I was looking at this tower when I was here the first time. That's a water tower.
Hell yes.
So yeah, blowing it up doesn't kill him, but the water will stun him for a little bit.
I knew that was gonna collapse. I knew it.
Venom Snake has Quiet with him. And you can use her to, like, very briefly stun him with sniper fire, but if he gets sniped, he'll fucking shoot her. He'll he'll get her with the shots, too. He's really accurate with his fireballs.
She'll never moon you again.
What works against a man on fire? How about smoke grenades?
Sure, where there's smoke, there's fire, so you throw the smoke grenades to lead him away.
Yeah, he gets confused by smoke. I wouldn't say he doesn't like it.
So does Vapor Snake, we have established.
Yeah. Decoys, go!
Nope.
He's not affected by their compliments either. If you're going for like, oh, maybe try to like pop it underneath him to take out his stamina. Man, fire has no stamina. Rocket arm. It bounces off him. Like, it's a little hard to see, but you can see it just whoop, flying off the side of the screen. Keep in mind, when we rescued the children, they gave us reward that was a blueprint for a squirt gun. So, once we distract him with some smoke grenades, let's call in the water gun.
Oh my god. Oh my god. This game.
However, there is a danger calling in supplies for this mission. If your supply box drops near Man of Fire, he'll blow it up. He just destroyed my box, and everything inside it is gone. We looked over that cliff face, and there is a river down there. There's jeeps here, so what if we just rammed them? Take this!
That's my boy. That's my dude right there.
I love it. I had no idea this was even a possibility, but it's so cool that you can run him off a cliff face into the river.
That's so satisfying.
And it's like an intended thing.
That's
It's not like a weird bug. It's so cool. It's such a cool solution to a boss fight.
Oh, the range on this has got to be garbage.
It's not very good. Take this!
I love the look of it, though. I love it.
I love that every little squirt that hits him, he goes, oof. The water gun has 20 shots, but infinite reloads. The water pistol, since it squirts such small amounts of water, takes many, many, many shots to do anything to the man on fire. You can try and fold the man on fire.
Wait, you want to extract him? Good idea. I want to know what he really is. The hell? Your bullets aren't hitting him.
And also, I developed a new drug called Acceleramen. Taking this pill just automatically activates reflex mode for you. So I'm just trying to shoot this fucking kid. Take this, child. But if we just keep stunning him, and we keep shooting the psychic child, once you shoot him enough.
So the kid disappears. Man on fire stops. I guess that worked. Good job as always, boss.
Face down, ass up.
But yeah, if you want to Fulton the man on fire out of the mission area, you have to shoot the psychic kid 20 times.
Oh my god.
And the 20th shot will finally land. If you've upgraded your C4 enough, or if you just have a lot of C4 planted, you can use that to toss him around like this.
Nice. These are all much more interesting things than kiting him around to the water buckets.
Yeah. And then, if you are just absolutely completely stumped or having a really hard time, like, timing the water towers to blow up near him, if you're in this fight for more than 10 minutes, it starts to rain.
Oh!
Thank you, Mother Nature. Get out of there, boss.
And, get this, there's still two other ways to beat him, but I can't do them yet because you need items you can't get until later in the game.
But the car was so good.
It's so cool.
That's the canonical way to beat him.
Yeah, absolutely.
That's in the novelization. It better fucking be.
Yeah. Woof. I failed my mission. That child died, by the way.
Oh, yeah.
He's
okay.
Super dead.
Well, no refunds. Sorry,
yeah,
kid.
Sorry. Hey, kids, I'm back.
So, about your friend. He went to a farm, and he can run and play all day long.
I like whenever Miller describes somebody else in the war business, and he always speaks of them with such disgust in his voice. But I think it's not because he's disgusted by them, but rather disgusted that he didn't do it first.
Boss, we have an emergency.
What?
Mother base is under attack.
What?
God damn it.
The enemy is over on one of our platforms.
Every 10 years.
Time to do a different mission, actually. We were about to do mission 21, but let's go to 22 instead because it's so urgent.
So this is an actual mission. This is not how you start doing like the multiplayer invasion stuff.
Right, this is like an actual scripted mission, and it always happens the first time you you try to do mission 21.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because that seemed like an alert for like the multiplayer incursion stuff.
Yeah.
Hey Huey, what do you want to do for your birthday this year? I don't know, maybe make a walking nuclear tank? You say that every year.
He's so easy to get gifts for. The R&D strut is a navigational nightmare.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing is laid out in a way that makes sense. It's like, okay, it's very tall. Let's take the stairs all the way up to the top. Like, random staircases just terminate halfway up, and some only go from the top to the middle and don't connect to the ground. It gets very confusing, and it's very hard to figure out how to get all the way up to the top. Each strut has its own, like, target practice mission. R&D has one too, and it's the hardest one because it isn't, it's so big and tall and it's hard to navigate, and like they
I really like that transition though to the horizontal
pipe. It's cool.
Oh, that was such a good animation. That was so cool.
Yeah, it's a really good animation. I just want to see in some game like this an enemy behavior one day where they see a giant pile of knocked out guys and they go, nope. And they go the opposite way. They don't go to check on their friends to see what's happening. They just go the opposite way. I mean, it's also like, I don't even need to rescue them now. Like, I've taken care of everybody.
They're home.
You're already home. I'll just cut your handcuffs off. But no, you still have to Fulton them.
Yeah, there's a procedure. It is a military, after all. Regulations must be observed. Yeah.
Either that, or they just been a little traumatized from being held hostage, and they just need the comforting embrace of the Fulton to calm them down.
Plus 60 fame. He rescued his own men, who were on their own base, by sending them off the base for a very short amount of time. And that's a hero.
Alright, come here, you.
If you want to be recognized, don't wear a full face mask.
Yeah. His skill is a boaster. The boaster skill means that he just lies about his skills. So he was actually an A++ in combat and not an S. Titanium Moose. Titanium Moose is great. I love
the
him.
The Bastard Serpent, or as we know him, Liquid Snake.
So, Mosquito was, in fact, in Ground Zeroes. You can see him in this cutscene. He was the guy who helped Miller get up. There he is. He still has Mosquito written on the back of his vest. It's great. But basically, here's the thing. We can have multiple mother bases now. They're forward operating bases, and we can build them in different waters that have different materials, resources that you can mine. Obviously, I want to get the one that has fuel as an S, because it's the biggest resource bottleneck in the game.
Right.
I already purchased one FOB, and the first one they give you for free. If you want any more, though, you gotta pay with Mother Base coins, which cost real money. This costs 600 Mother Base coins, which is $6. When you start building them, they have timers, and it's like, oh, that takes an hour for the first one. And it's like, do you not want to wait an hour, though? Well, that's fine. Just give us Mother Base coins. Give us 20 Mother Base coins. Come on. Thank you.
And now you're a hero. For paying your microtransaction, become a hero.
So the good thing is none of those Mother Base coins I have I paid for, because in this game, as long as you're connected to the internet, there's a daily login bonus. And sometimes those bonuses are Mother Base coins. So all those coins I have right now have been accumulated over the entire course of this LP.
Aha, see? See, there's a plan. That's why.
Yeah.
That's why we're taking breaks, to farm free money.
Yeah. There's a thing I really wanted to do with Vapor Snake, but I cannot fucking figure out how to do it, if there is even a way.
You've built some ugly ass guns.
Yeah, these guns get fucking ugly, man. I also want to point out that, like...
Oh, look at it. Oh.
Yeah, it's just awful. Nothing matches. I want to point out the scope on this gun is two scopes combined, actually. It's a scope pointed at a magnifier scope so that it magnifies more than it should. I cannot believe this is an option they give you, but you can do that. In the PC version of Metal Gear Solid 5, when it first came out, before it got patched, there was a bug, basically, where if you're using, like, a controller, but also using the mouse to select things at the same time, you could slap gun customization parts on slots that made no fucking sense. One of the best examples was you could just slap a suppressor on a grenade. And
hell
so
yes.
The actual 3D model of the grenade that you would hold in-game, it just had a suppressor glued to it, and it worked. When you threw grenades, guards could not hear the grenades explode. You can kind of customize some rocket launchers.
What the fuck is that?
I don't know why you would want a flashlight on your RPG, but you can do it.
I've never seen a gun that begged for death before, but...
Oh, man. Anyways, we got this...
Of all the people to want this to exist, this is wildly out of character for Big Boss.
Yeah.
He flipped his shit when he saw a knife with a hollow handle.
Yeah.
And now this Frankenstein-ass gun is like, yeah, sure, hell yes.
Yeah. The thing was, it wasn't even just like, oh, you could put a suppressor on a grenade. It was like, you could have a... You could make an entire gun and then strap it onto another gun as if it was the barrel of the gun. And then you could take another gun and put it on the scope of the top gun, so you had, like, a stack of three guns. And Big Boss's reload animations would get all fucked up and his arms would twist through his body and stuff. It was so good!
I would like to roleplay this game as Cable. That would be nice, yeah. That must be the arms dealer. His next move will be to meet the target. So, to walk 15 feet to his left.
Yeah. Iemand heeft mij verteld dat Christian iemand zoals hij te slaan zou komen. Our contract explicitly said no big bosses.
No legendary soldiers. All soldiers must be entirely run of the mill and frankly drab.
Look, my contract said we would not be facing any soldiers above B rank. So, you got any questions about the neighborhood?
Great schools. They just built a brand new wing.
Oh. I see the neighborhood watch all has walker gears, too.
Yeah, there was an angel investor. Named Raphael of the Order of Swords. Benitez se diamante sal nogal 'n lekker payday wees. 'N Meisie se beste vriend natuurlik, hè.
Dis PA vir jou. Elke sukker se skrouende girlfriend. I also work for K Jewelers.
Okay, so we're talking about the end of streetcars and rail in America. We're talking about fucking De Beers. We're just stripping. We're laying bare the undergirders of American capitalism.
Yeah.
Is this game too real for you?
Whoa.
Anyway, I like that as soon as that guy mentions nuclear weapons, the other guy turns into Woody Allen. That's fun. That's a fun moment.
They feed off the conflict and turn around and blame the colonial governments? Now that's hypocrisy.
Miller!
I noticed that Miller doesn't say anything about their diamond sales when he is selling the diamonds you steal from their camps.
Yeah.
Before they can sell them first.
Yeah. Thankfully, we can get around a little easier, especially since there's, like, lots of walker gears around here, because I developed some stealth camo.
I thought you were just gonna take the truck.
Nope.
Because... Trucks are how you win this game. We learned that so long ago.
Though I can't drive the truck into this building, so that's a bit of a problem.
Hell yes. Look at that. Look at that thing.
Yep.
What is that?
I can't tell. What? It's so camouflaged. Also, because we're good enough friends with Quiet, we've unlocked a new outfit for her. Yay, we can put clothes on her. Or rather, we could put clothes on her, but instead we got an outfit that just drenches her in fake blood.
Oh,
why?
That's so much worse. That's a million times worse.
What? A special blood-soaked naked uniform that Quiet wears only for those who fight by her side. The fake blood is designed to strike fear into her enemies. What?
Yeah, it fucking would.
Our intel suggests the target will leave the country with the arms dealer after the inspection. Take him out before that happens.
Yep, that's fine.
Oh no, I think they know you're here. I do love Quiet in your ear being like, oh, so it's one of those today, huh?
Yeah.
That's how we're doing this one?
Mm-hmm.
You brought your grenade pistol? That's cool.
The mother base coins, like any mobile game or anything that has lots of microtransactions, they have a best value package.
Mm-hmm. Where it's like, spend $100 and...
Yeah. The highest... I think you can buy... 1,000 Mother Base coins for $60. So you get a discount on it, I guess. Or is it 1,000? No, that would be $10. Maybe it's 10,000. Anyways, the largest amount of Mother Base coins you can buy costs 60 fucking bucks. And there's something they don't really... like explicitly tell you, but it's in like the fine print. So say you buy $60 worth of Mother Base coins.
Sure.
And then it's like, oh, I'm downloading another game on Steam, but I'm kind of running out of space on my hard drive. I haven't been playing a ton of Metal Gear recently, so I'll uninstall it and then like reinstall it later when I want to play more. If you uninstall Metal Gear Solid 5 in your PC, you lose all Mother Base coins you paid for.
Of course you do. Why would it be any other way?
Even
why?
Even though it's like they keep track of your all of your stats and stuff for the online stuff, even after you uninstall, if I remember correctly, like it's no, it goes away. Absurd. Also, because they have to cover like all of their bases, like the EOLA that pops up for this game when you start it up also says right, like please don't start relationships over Metal Gear Online.
She's only after you for your mother base coins, bro.
Damn it. Grizzly squirrel.
That's not a real thing.
Doom kangaroo.
That is a real thing.
Fire kangaroo, his brother.
Questionable.
Howling shark. Don't think they can do that. But punching sloth. Watch out.
Easy to dodge. I'll say that.
Boss, about that target you extracted. He says he wants to work for us. Having talked to him, he doesn't seem that bad a guy.
Anyway, we gonna sell nukes now or what?
Yeah.
Let's fucking go.
I mean, have you looked at this guy's resume? Okay, it's time to talk about... Oh, wait, hold on. We got our daily login bonus. Cool.
Uh-huh.
That's cool. Our PF grade updated. We got PF points? Cool.
There's so many points.
Oh, wait, my PF grade decreased from C to C minus.
Oh, okay.
And my worldwide ranking went... my espionage rating, up. It's the same, but it went down a little bit. Okay. Cool. Well, anyways... Oh, wait! There's an FOB event underway! All right.
Cool.
Yep. Reminding me how many Mother Base coins I have. This is part of the reason why when I've been doing the Let's Play, I've disconnected the game from the internet, because those happen all the time! Oh look, there's my daily bonus, 35 Mother Base coins. Hooray.
Hey, that's a third of a dollar.
Yeah. Hey y'all, do you want to get insurance for your Mother Base? Well, you can! So it costs Mother Base coins. 3-day insurance is free the first time. 14 days is 300 Mother Base coins.
First taste is free, baby.
Yeah, man. There's also FOB events, which are like basically just missions that they aren't against other actual players. Those get cycled out every month or so. They still get cycled out now, which tells me Konami has like one person in a basement managing the Metal Gear Solid 5 servers. Another thing is when you're doing FOB stuff, you get more rewards if you shittier soldiers. So I would get double the rewards if I had used Seething Crow.
Yeah, but then you wouldn't win because he's Seething fucking Crow. Yeah.
They also added updates like last year to play as Ocelot or Quiet in FOBs.
Nice.
They have different stats, but they play the same in FOB stuff. You can play as Ocelot and Quiet in Metal Gear Online as well, and they actually have some of their like own like unique abilities. So yeah, like there's this weird force field that gets put around the mother base to kind of show that like you're not in the playable area yet or something. But also there's a time limit to these missions. So like mother base, this base will lock down and it'll get blockaded in about 18 minutes, which means like you cannot escape and like you lose. I can find a decent amount of, mother bases that are, like, super decked out. But the issue is, they are so decked out, it's literally impossible for me to, like, win at this point in the game. Because, like, the tactical boy has won. No rewards there, but... Even if you don't steal anything, you still get a bunch of resources, and you get guys to... You just recruit some of that person's soldiers, no matter what, even if you don't steal them. Wow, I'm number one in my group ranking, because no one's playing! Yeah, part of the issue is, like, when this game first released, weapons could get developed up to a rank of, like, 6 or 8, and then through lots of patches to the multiplayer, they added more and more increasingly powerful weapons so that there is just a constant arms race to keep playing your base, like, keep upgrading your base so that your shit wouldn't get stolen. So now weapons go up to rank 15. and, like, rank 15 weapons, like, each weapon costs, like, millions upon millions of GMP and thousands of resources to make. And, like, there's a point where it's, like this base, every single soldier is wearing the heavy armor. So it's hard to kill them. They don't have helmets on, at least, but, best version of that armor caused soldiers to take, like, a shitload of hits. Because they also, the later versions also have helmets, so you couldn't headshot them. But then they patched the game to add an even stronger version of an armor-piercing sniper rifle that could kill those guys in one hit, regardless of where you shot them. And so it was just like every like couple of months, it was just like, okay, we added a new gun that annihilates everybody. And they're like, okay, we added new armor that makes that gun useless. And it just kept going back and forth like that. Even if you have like S++ guys, and it's like, that's the only rank of dude you have, and they have completely filled up all your bases, and you've, like, filled up 2 FOBs with all those dudes, it's still like, oh, you're still not a high enough rank to make the absolute best sniper rifle. You need to get another FOB, a third one. And it's like, that costs $10. No thank you. We might come back later in case I find any really cool bases, that have an appropriate amount of defenses for where I am in the game right now. Because I'm never going to get to the point where I can truly combat the best dudes. Like, some of the best people that who are still, like, playing this have, like... You can see how many times they've won, and they've won, like, 3,000 times. I'm not going to do that!
If you want to see how development's going, come take a look for yourself.
No, fuck it. You show me, okay? I'm busy.
Just send me a picture over the iDroid. Come on.
I'm attacking FOBs 3,000 times.
Yeah. I gotta grind for that Brennan sniper rifle.
I mean, I also love DD, but it's specifically the dog.
Hey, boss, do you not hate me yet? Look, I made a mug! All right. Well, Huey has made... the body and a leg.
He made a box. He made a weird box. Star Wars luggage.
There's not even any like mechanics or anything inside that thing right now. It's just full of more Diamond Dog mugs. He didn't even build it. That's just how they were shipped. He's gonna... he just took the box. He's gonna build inside of it. Well, gotta take a shower before I shoot some children. And also because I'm good enough friends with Quiet now, I could tell her to just use a tranquilizer sniper rifle. Please don't shoot children in the head.
At least not fatally.
Yeah. Let's put him to sleep.
There's going to be a kind of festival held on Mother Base. They are calling it Peace Day. Snake and his men may be without a nation, but they are still an army. And that means sometimes they have to fight the bad guys.
Were her diary tapes all like where you learn that she was working for Cypher and she fucking hated everybody?
There were also tapes that were still like under the guise of being Paz.
Okay.
But I'm kind of under the impression that these tapes may have actually been made now-ish because she still thinks she's just like a high school girl.
And anything is better than letting Miller sing. Oh, that was mean. Miller said he was going to write a song for us. I wonder what he
If Miller today heard this tape, he would throw her off the edge.
Oh yeah, totally. They get very spooked if a trank dart whizzes past them. Thankfully, they can't throw grenades half a mile at me. We also have this tape of hot Paz humming. Like the first bar of Love Deterrence. That also attracts them. But it's not as effective as, like, playing the actual song, because, like, they get attracted to you, but once they get near you, they just go like, what the?
Only children were left. All those kids were ever taught was how to fight, and now they're free at the control of adults.
One of them has a conch shell. I'm very concerned.
We're going to disarm, demobilize, and reintegrate them. A DDR operation. To begin with, extract their commander to Mother Base.
Then, give them an arcade cabinet.
Yeah.
The rest of the group will fall apart by itself.
You really think the DDR mission is like a Konami wink wink nudge nudge?
I don't know.
Who's Konami beat Mania? I forget.
They're DDR.
Boss, okay.
None of the tests we did once you were back at the base revealed a pathogen that could have caused them. Meaning we don't have a single sample to work with. Everything went up in flames.
Well, it also means there's no potentially deadly pathogens on base, so can you focus on the silver lining here?
That's good, though.
Right?
I'm surprised you never... There's no cutscene of, like, Big Boss getting, like, put in quarantine for a second before they go, like, you're good.
Yeah, that'd be fucking cool.
Only 5% of the world's population is a native English speaker. But when you factor in those who've acquired it as a second language, nearly one-third of the people speak it. The world's dominant lingua franca. You gotta figure they had it somewhere among all the languages.
Skull's face was just trying to develop like a new way to teach languages to people, and he really fucked up. We
couldn't isolate. Yeah, this is the secret history of Duolingo.
Well, the program could have been set to change every day.
No wonder why the owl seems so sinister. I was, when I recorded the previous episode, I was like surprised to see the insurance thing because I did not remember that being there, and I'm pretty sure it was a thing they actually patched in later. because lots of people were, like, very paranoid and concerned about, like, their shit getting stolen, because it's like, you don't even have to be playing the game for your base to be invaded.
Right, yeah.
Because, like, every time I do a recording, even when they're, like, weeks apart, I'll come back and it's, like, my base has been invaded, like, 3 times. Like, thankfully, I have never lost a ton of stuff. And I will never pay for insurance. Anytime I see a video game offer, like, actual insurance for something, I just squint. I squint a lot.
The kids ended up on their own. Must have been like fish out of water. Nothing to eat.
So they immediately died.
All the adults taught them was how to use a gun. Sure, they could shoot.
So they ate the guns.
I guess somebody wished upon a star, because their savior turned up like stardust straight out of the blue.
Miller?
What? At least he hasn't lost his sense of poetry.
Yeah. Hey, kids. Your uncle's here. What you doing? Hanging out?
Which one of you is a deadly snake? I mean, besides me. Just a little fun.
I was hired to kill all of you. It's one of those missions.
Okay.
Yep. Oh, man.
Can I guess?
Hmm. I have a feeling that you can... You've got a pretty good guess.
Okay.
Yeah, we'll have two playthroughs for this. We got Big Boss. We'll also have a little bit of Vapor Snake near the end. No Ooh. Venom Snake, obviously. I can't shoot children. It's game over, man. And it's not even like, oh, you kill a kid, then it's game over. It's like, if you shoot them with even one bullet, it's like, it stops. The game just stops.
Boss, I've put together a new form of street dance in order to connect to the youth today. I call it crumping.
By the way, if you try to grab a kid, you can't. They're too small. The children are too small to get in a proper CQC grab.
But you are encouraged to punch them unconscious.
Yep. Trying to think what Miller would be into.
Kiss. Miller's a Kiss fan.
I feel like Peace Walker.
He thinks Beth is the most romantic song ever written.
Okay, I agree that Peace Walker era Miller fucking loves Kiss. But I feel like Phantom Pain era Miller would denounce ever even liking Kiss.
Mm-hmm. I mean, they're in tactical disguise
That's
all
true.
The time.
Yeah.
They're fully undercover. No one can reveal their identities.
I remember when I first played this game, and like, from the trailers, I knew there was gonna be like child soldiers in it, but I was like, oh, are they gonna actually do the thing that has been insinuated in previous games of him like actually killing kids? And I was like, mm-hmm. there's no way they would let you do that in gameplay, but maybe in a cutscene or something. But, like, when I was playing it, and it's just like, oh, you gotta tranquilize the kids.
Subject is in.
I was like, oh, I feel like they might be kind of backing away from what they said Big Boss did, but then I was like, no, you're still punching the shit out of them. And I mean, that's still kind of fucked up. Like, I think I just whiffed that shot, but even if you're much closer and you try to headshot him, he will dodge out of the way. It is still possible to, like, trank him from far away. He's just too far away. I don't really know how to gauge
the shot. Hey, quiet, the shot. Trank the child.
Yeah, I could have done that if I brought her back to this base. But it is also possible to knock him out by hitting him in the face with an empty magazine. It's just hard to do, because he's very aware of his surroundings, so...
All we need is a firm, cybernetic boy punching. All this is just obfuscating the point.
Mm-hmm. It's your new dad. Here I come.
Just checking on you. It lights out.
Mm-hmm.
To put your lights out.
Padina ange yandi. Yina yabo ke bangaka. Nyoke yampembe.
All right, let's fight the child.
Yes, yes. Rufio.
Honestly, if you just stay still, you can just fucking trump him. Anytime he comes at you, you can very easily counter him with CQC.
Yeah.
He also throws beer bottles at you. I love that you can just smack it out of the air. It's so good. As Vapor Snake, though.
Ooh.
You know, the White Mamba very easily will dodge sniper fire. Rocket Arms, on the other hand, he is completely unaware of. He also says that quote, you know, that one. And the instant you, like, beat him, like, all the kids just start scattering. Even if they see you, they'll just keep running away. But yeah, I like that little boss fight. It's not very hard, but it's fun. I like all the different ways he can counter his moves, like smacking the beer bottle out of the air. It's great. Because there's like...
And it does play him up as really capable, but also you're just chomping on some child.
Yeah, like, that kid is really fucking good at fighting, and Big Boss is just on such a different level.
Yeah.
I really like, there's no, like, effort in, like, that beer bottle smack. It's just, he's just casually deflects it. Take this, child!
You're pretty good.
And now you're just teasing the poor thing.
Which one's your real dad? You don't know.
You're pretty good. You're pretty good. As you're getting your ass beat.
Early in this video, you talked like, you joked about the kids having a conch shell because it's very... The description of the kids is very Lord of the Flies sounding, but the white mamba literally has a conch shell hanging from his waist. Yep. Very early on, in like episode 4 or 5 of this Let's Play or something, I joked that, like, you know, Kojima read about 3 books for this game. Lord of the Flies is one of them. And also, I forgot to point it out. I'll put it back. I'll edit it in the video later on. The pig's head, the severed pig's head that's on the table in front of the white mamba, if you shoot it with a gun, it squeals. Hey kids, got you a new friend. Hope you like him.
Just remember to take turns playing with the battle gear and... Alright, one of you's gotta take D-Dog for a walk.
Yeah.
I don't know if you wanna make a schedule or what, but...
We got rules around here. Never draw a weapon on a fellow soldier. You got that.
Also, if you do anything bad, I break your arms. That's the other rule.
That does seem to be a consistent rule.
I'm a doctor. I have an A+ in medicine.
Anyone here can use medicine.
I don't know shit about cysts, though.
Nah. Do you think he smokes so the kids go away faster?
Thank you for taking in those animals, boss.
Oh, you're welcome.
Don't talk about the kids like that.
Whoa.
Oh my god, the cat is dead.
The cat's dead.
The cat is... Oh no!
Like, the cat could totally be alive at this point, because it's only been 9 years, and like, the cat looks pretty young. But, like, Mother Base blew the fuck up.
Yeah.
Like, the only other chance is that, like, the soldiers that did evacuate, one of them took the cat with them. It has been... Like, an occasional in-joke between me and Voidburger pauses voice acting, but over time it has slowly kind of, like, evolved into not sounding like Paz and sounding more like Ren from Ren and Stimpy.
Miller, you idiots!
But as I was wondering how to break it to Miller, Professor Galvez took out an odd instrument.
A gun!
Why not abandon war and just make music together?
It's so simple.
But anyway,
and that's how Paz invented Eurovision.
We just get all the world leaders together and just go, hey guys, what if we started a band? Huey will be on drums.
Oh no, the drums are full of poison gas. Who could have known? Why? The drums are standing up and walking away.
Oh no! Oh man, the drums can launch nukes. Every fucking thing he makes, man! Quiet, don't do that yoga thing. Don't. Let's just be normal friends. By normal friends, I mean neither of us will talk, ever, to each other.
Or to anyone else.
Yeah, pretty much. Much.
They were originally the researchers' accommodations. The threat level seems relatively
close. Ocelot. I was listening to him.
Sorry, Miller was saying some boring-ass bullshit.
Try to think, like, between...
That's how I get out of the car.
Yeah, me too. Between Big Boss, Miller, and Ocelot, I have a feeling that there's not enough work between all of them for all of them to stay busy at all times running Mother Base. So what does Ocelot do in his downtime? He doesn't really seem to like twirling guns anymore. It's not his thing. He grew out of it.
Mm-hmm. Well, he'll rediscover it at a later time.
That's true. He's in his phase where he thinks everything he did when he was a little bit younger is dumb. I love that the other dude, like, when all these people are coming to get them, he just walks out the back of the tent Bye.
There, that's the target.
It takes him a while to notice that he just walks away, too.
That's how he got to be such an expert researcher. Always do the unexpected.
People praise him for how productive he was, but it was just because he was really good at walking out of meetings without being noticed.
Like, we were cultivating the pathogen. Are you from around here? You don't know anything.
Yeah, both of these people are very chatty. And it's easy to miss out on this dialogue because you're probably most likely just going to immediately Fulton them.
Right.
The first time I played this, like, I started faulting them, and then they, both of them started their long monologue, like, as they were flying into the sky, and I was like, no! Wait, come back! What were you gonna say? Well, was it important?
I was asked to show that man around here.
There's weird pathogen, we kinda just cultivated it. I left on my own, but Eric there, oh man, he's probably swimming in that shit.
Yeah.
That coward ran off without me.
Well, Okay, yeah, that's good. You don't hold it against him, because you're still going to be co-workers. You are hereby fired from your previous job, and you work for me now. You have no say in this.
If you don't want to work for me, I will put you in jail until you do.
Yeah.
All right, you're out of the hot zone. No enemy forces in pursuit.
I don't know. Anytime these two are together, it sounds like a pretty hot zone. Got some tense working conditions by the end there.
Do we have, like, like an HR unit yet from Mother Base? I'm getting a feeling we're going to need one.
We know we will have one as soon as Miller is fired.
We are not your kind of people.